Hello everyone, welcome back to Chemical Engineering and Assessment channel. As you know, these days we are focusing on the module of Chemical Reaction Engineering. So in this regard, we are bringing the lecture number 35 for our valuable viewers. So in today's course coverage, we will again focus on chapter number 7. In lecture 34, we had seen the algorithm for the analysis of rare data. And in today's course coverage, we will see the various methods which can be used, analyze, and to find out the values of rare data, such as the value of K or value of activation energy. So there will be two methods which we will be discussing today. Number one is the method of excess, and number two is the integral method. So in method of excess, first we see that batch reactors are primarily used to determine the rate law parameters for the homogeneous reactions, and we had seen that packed bed reactors are used for heterogeneous systems. Now, how we can achieve it, or how we can determine the rate law parameters using the batch reactor for homogeneous system, by measuring concentration as a function of time, and then we can use either the integral or differential or nonlinear regression method to determine the reaction order and specific reaction rate constant. We had seen the method of excess in the algorithm, that we can use these three, integral, differential or nonlinear regression methods, to determine the reaction order. If some other reaction parameter is measured other than concentration, for example, its pressure is measured, then we have to rewrite the mole balance in terms of the measured variable, which could be the pressure, which could be the number of moles as well. For irreversible reaction, we have to determine the reaction order and the specific reaction rate constant, which is alpha and K respectively, by either the nonlinear regression or by numerically differentiating concentration versus time data. The latter method, which is the second method, by numerical differentiation of concentration versus time data, is most applicable when the reaction conditions are such that the rate of reaction is a function of concentration of one reactant, like for the decomposition reaction, that A goes to products, and we can write minus RA is equal to K of A C A raised to power alpha, where alpha is the reaction order, K is the specific reaction rate constant, and for this system and for such system, this differential method can be used. Now let's assume an irreversible reaction, that A plus B goes to products, and the rate of reaction or kinetic equation can be written as minus R of A is equal to K of A C A raised to power alpha C of B raised to power beta, where alpha and beta are the respective orders for these species, and alpha plus beta will give the overall order of the reaction. Now we need to perform the two experiments over here. Like if we say that excess A experiment, if you remember our example number 5.1, where we had said that water is in excess. So once it is in excess, we had taken it out from the kinetic equation, or we had said that it is the pseudo first order system. So we have to make the second order system as a pseudo first order by making sure that the concentration of one of the species is in excess. Excess A experiment means that the CA remains unchanged. Accordingly, minus RA is equal to K of A, CA raised to power alpha, CB raised to power beta. C of A remains unchanged. It means that it will be equal to CA naught. So K of A, CA naught will become as K double prime, which means that it is now a pseudo first order system. And now we can determine the value of beta and K double prime over here. In the same way, we can carry out excess B experiment, that C of B remains unchanged during the course of the reaction. Accordingly, that CB will become equal to CB naught, that KA CB naught will become K prime, accordingly K prime CA raised to power alpha. And now we can determine the value of alpha and K prime. Once alpha and beta are determined, KA can be calculated from the measurement of minus RA. How we can calculate KA? Minus RA over CA raised to power alpha, CB raised to power beta. We have calculated alpha and beta over here. We know, already know the concentration, the rate of reaction will be known, so we can calculate the value of K from that system. So that is the method of excess, where we have to make sure that we have to make it a first order system, or we can say simply a pseudo first order system. Going to the integral method, it is the quickest method, as we have seen earlier, to determine the rate law. But the condition is if the reaction order is zero or first or second order. What we have to do in this method, that we have to simply guess it. Guess the reaction order in the combined batch reactor mole balance equation, which will be dCA over dt is equal to minus kCA raised to power alpha, we had derived it earlier in our previous lectures. And now we have to assume the alpha first, like if it's a zero order, make the equation and then integrate. If it is first order or if it is second order, we have to simply put the value of alpha here and then we have to integrate the differential equation to obtain concentration as a function of time. If the reaction order which we have assumed, for example, if it is zero order or first order or second order, which we have assumed and that comes out to be true, how we can detect it? That the plot which will be generated, it will be a linear plot of the concentration time data. But mostly, if we see, integral method is used when the reaction order is known and it is desired to evaluate the specific reaction rate constant at different temperatures to determine the activation energy. So there are two advantages of this method. Number one is that if the reaction order is unknown, we can guess it, and if the guess is right, we can determine it by making sure that the plot is the linear plot. And the second one is that the most applications of this method comes when the reaction order is known and we have to determine the specific reaction rate constant at different temperatures to determine the activation energy. And it is important to note that how we can generate the plots. Let's come to the zero, first and second orders. For zero order, the equation will be dCA over dt is equal to RA, and that will be equal to minus K. Once we differentiate it, at time t is equal to 0, CA is equal to CA naught, and at time t is equal to t, CA is equal to CA, CA is equal to CA naught minus KT. So that is Y is equal to MX plus C, where Y is CA, M is minus K, T is X, and intercept is CA naught. So this plot will be generated between time and CA. For first order, we say dCA over dt is equal to RA and that is equal to minus KCA. At time t is equal to 0, CA is equal to CA naught. At time t is equal to t, CA is equal to CA. Once we integrate it, we get natural log of CA naught over CA is equal to KT. Again, Y is equal to MX plus C where C is 0. So Y is natural log of CA naught over CA. As you can see here, X axis T and the slope will be K. And for second order system, dCA over dt is equal to RA and that is equal to minus KCA square. Again, the same limits for integral. And we get 1 over CA minus 1 over CA naught is equal to KT. Or we can say 1 over CA is equal to 1 over CA naught plus KT, where T is the x-axis, 1 over CA at y-axis, and the slope will be K. So if we assume that the reaction is zero order, the slope should be like this between time and C of A. For first order, the graph will be plotted between T and natural log of CA naught over CA, and if it is a linear plot, it's a first order. If it's a second order, the plot will be between T and 1 over CA, and again it should be a linear plot. And if these three does not occur, it means we cannot use the integral method and we have to use some other technique. So that's how we can use these two methods, the method of excess which we have studied earlier in today's lecture, and now the integral method can be used to determine the reaction order and specific reaction rate constant. So I hope you have understood all the aspects of this lecture. In the next lecture, we will be solving an example to demonstrate the use of these methods. So that's it from today's lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also, click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos on this channel.